let me give you what I teach the guys. You want to get a lot of bass in your voice. I don't care how you do that, but you can't go over there and not have a man's voice. And when you're getting ready to call her on the phone, I want you to get as much bass in your voice as you can. Work at it. Get it down there. Get ready to pick up the phone. Get your voice, bass in your voice. That means I'm a man. That's what that bass means. I'm a man. The way you say something, in tone, is what I'm talking about, sensuality. The difference between Dexter's a great TV show and Dexter is a great TV show. Mm-hmm. I love it. There's a big difference in the words are the same roughly, but it's how you say it. And if you can, acting. If you can take acting, speech, persuasive speech, you're going to learn some basics about how to do this. When I worked for Bechtel, they sent me to all these classes that they paid for on persuasive speaking and communicating and so on. And I learned a lot of that before I was even involved in psychology. So it's something you can learn without going into therapy. It's something you learn on your own, is how to control your voice and make yourself sensual. Women want to be sensual. Women are emotional. Men are rational. And if you want to really interact with a woman on the right level, you want to be sensual. You don't want to be logical, rational, reasonable. You want to be sensual and emotional. Hope that helps.
Now, I know a lot of guys out there, they have pretty weak vocals. Their toenail is really weak.
Yes, it's very important. Our girls, I mean, some of these guys are such quiet speakers that the girls tell them, you know, you're never going to get anywhere. You got to speak up like a man. You can't be passive. You can't be, hi, I'm Jim, how are you? Hi, I'm Jim, how you doing? It's much different. And if she has to strain to hear your voice, she's not interested. So, again, speech, acting 101, I hate to beat this horse, but that's where you learn how to do this, especially if you came from a family. I have to go off on a little psychological side trip here, man. A lot of guys I work with were raised in families where they learned to survive by being quiet and not get hit, or being quiet and not get ridiculed. So now they're 30 years old, and they're using survival skills from this nut house they grew up in to avoid getting hurt. Well, it's working because no women are going to go out with them, so you're not going to get hurt. So what we have to do is we have to change ourselves. The world is not going to change. You can only control yourself, and you have to become more assertive, more outgoing, and you have to have a lot of bass in your voice, and you have to control your sensuality in your voice, especially on the phone, guys. I mean, I would say these guys I've been working with in groups since 96, I would say the biggest moment they blow it is on the first phone call, and it's basically over. And one of my titanium babes spent almost a half a day on, you got to give good phone. Yeah, so she was an actor, and they're all actors. Every girl hires an actor from Hollywood, and they all have had all these lessons. So she actually took everybody, sat them down. We all did role-playing with phones, including me, and then she would switch seats with us and say, okay, this is how I want you to do it, and then you do it. And then, in other words, you're getting instant feedback from a female on how to do phones. But in general, let me give you guys a warning. Women have a 10-to-1 advantage over you on the phone. The longer you're on the phone, the more in jeopardy you are. So you'll learn from me, get on the phone, exchange amenities, be polite, be friendly, and get off the phone. Do not chat. Do not discuss a lot of stuff. She can read every nuance of your talk. She can know what the pause in speech means. She can know what it means when your voice goes up, when it goes down, when you trail off, when you go up. She can read it all. She's never read a single book. She knows exactly what's going on with you. So the longer you're on the phone, the more at jeopardy you are in blowing this whole thing. You have to keep your mystery. You have to gradually let her get to know you. You can't dump it all out there on the first date, second date, third date, first, second, third, fourth, fifth phone call. No. They want the mystery. They want the excitement of the unknown. It's all part of the courtship game.